Oh, racist. Give me a break.
What are you going to do with the thousands of Muslims?
We certainly
American will. Citizens who are serving in the military.
I'm sure that we just couldn't possibly survive with all those Muslim Navy Rangers. Yes, I'm sure that's true.
That is not right.
No. I'm talking about
you cannot
about
make
Muslim
fun of people who are saving our lives.
They want special holidays and special food in
so
school.
So if you don't like their religion, you don't have to join them. That's fine.
Well, no,
but,
they are.
But you can't discriminate against them simply because you.
Of course, anyone should have the right to discriminate against anyone he wishes. And the point is.
But not by the law, Mr. Taylor. You can't do that.
I think the law is absolutely incorrect.
Do you feel that whites are superior? They're more intelligent than blacks.
I think on average, whites are more intelligent than blacks, and North Asians are more intelligent than whites.
How can you say that?
How can you think otherwise?
Mr. Taylor,
what evidence would you have to think that a pygmy is, on average, is just as intelligent as a Dane? Why would you think that? The entire record of history is completely consistent with the assumption that black Africans are less intelligent on average than Asians or Caucasians.
That's absurd. That's repugnant and absurd.
Repugnant to you?
Yes, of course.
Why would you even entertain the possibility that on average a pygmy is as intelligent as a Japanese?
The comparison that you are trying to make, It is simply impossible because of historical circumstances, because economic conditions, because of the movement.
More excuses. We have to be willing to say to all those who are non-European, we wish you well, but this territory is for us. And sorry, we have the right to be us, and only we can be us.
So you want me to leave?
Under certain circumstances, yes, we would ask you to go. Unless whites are prepared to exclude people, then they will be shoved aside. That is the fate which I will fight until my last breath.
Mr. Trump, I have a question about immigration.
Okay, who's next? Yeah, please.
Your immigration plan is
Excuse
full
me,
of
empty promises. Excuse me, sit down. Sit down.
Mr. Trump, no, I'm a reporter as an immigrant and as a U.S. citizen. I have the right to ask the question.
No, you
and
don't.
This is the question.
You haven't been called.
No, I have the right to ask the question.
Go back to Univision.
This is the question.
Go ahead.
You cannot deport 11 million.
Go ahead.
You cannot deport 11 million people. You cannot build a 1,900-mile wall. You cannot deny citizenship to children in this country.
Down,
and with those ideas, I'm a reporter and I have, don't touch me, sir.
Please,
don't touch me, sir. You cannot touch me. I have the right to ask a question.
Yes, in order, in terms,
I have the right to ask a question. I have the right to ask a question.
Let me see it.
It's over there.
So they're coming out, stay out. You just gotta wait your turn.
You're very rude. It's not about you.
It's not about
you. Get out of my country. Get out.
This is not about you. I'm a U.S. citizen, too.
Well, whatever. No, Univision, no. It's not about you.
It's not about you. It's about the United States.
No, it is. It's about us.
Hate is contagious. That expression of hate is something that I had never experienced before. It's something that I reported about, but never experienced it myself.